Demonstrators have been occupying Vancouver for 9 days now, and it's been a high cost for the city, and staff say they want it to end. But many are wondering when the city will crack down and if it will be peaceful. Justine Ma reports.
It's Mark Hoskins' third night camping out at the Vancouver Art Gallery, but it's a small sacrifice for change.
If we just keep this pressure on, things are already changing. And if we vote with our wallets and we do things that are eco-conscious, buying local, and really supporting the things that we're talking about here, we can change the world.
But critics say the week-long protest has gone on long enough. It has already cost the city $500,000 in additional policing and resources. On Saturday, hundreds of demonstrators occupied banks in the downtown core, urging people to close their accounts. City Councilor Suzanne Anton says it's time for the mayor to take action.
As the leader of the city, Gregor needs to set a timeline, another week. What is the timeline? Set that timeline and then invite everyone to leave.
The city says it's negotiating with demonstrators to stop the protests, but forcing people out is not an option, at least not right now.
To set a hard date and say that that the city will move in, and violence or not, I think is very irresponsible. It only inflames the situation.
That's what happened in Sydney when riot police broke up protests. And in Chicago, organizers there vowed their protests will continue, even after police arrested 130 demonstrators. This UBC law professor says if Vancouver's demonstrators remain peaceful, it'll be tough for the city to remove them.
Under the charter, the court has said, number one, that freedom of expression is important. Number two, that within expression, freedom of political expression such as this is especially important and therefore would require a high justification.
It still remains to be seen if and when the city will crack down. Justine Ma, CBC News, Vancouver.